Ridiculous. Is any news of FOMC and everything dumps now?
Good morning, Winnie. I think, yeah, it is economy related. People are taking shorts because unemployment is not low enough, not high enough. Maybe not, I don't know. But yeah, you had numbers about unemployment, and they were expecting an increase in unemployment, which would have ended up with FOMC decreasing rates in March. But it's one tick lower than, well, it didn't increase. It stayed the same. So there's not more people unemployed. It's the same as last month. So it's like Powell is failing to bring unemployment up so that people are poor. And I don't know exactly what the point is in having an increase in unemployment, but it's supposed to be bullish. But
I thought, I don't
if there's unemployment, it means people are not working and GDP is down. And well, if GDP is down, it's not a good thing. Yeah. But yeah, short term it's bearish, but long term for me it's really bullish because it means, well, it means inflation is not cooling off as much as people want it to. And well, if inflation is not cooling off, you know, Bitcoin is a kind of a tool against inflation, so. But yeah, short term it could be bearish. Instead of cutting in March, maybe they'll cut next year, or maybe they'll cut in June. I don't know, but doesn't change much for crypto. And also that number, you know, it's 3.7%. Expected was an increase to 3.8%. It's like one tick. So I don't know, we'll see if we get an overreaction from those numbers. Then it could be a nice opportunity on the stock market today, but like especially if you put a new low before below Wednesday's low, because yeah, Wednesday we had a down move, Thursday we had upward retrace. Actually, that upward retrace is more than a retrace because it put new all-time highs on some charts, not all of them, but yeah, we put a new all-time high thanks to people shorting, and that gave a well a short entry. No, Nasdaq didn't though. It's really S&P that did it. And yeah, maybe banking is gonna go down today. And you know, when banks go down, we've seen Bitcoin go up. So yeah, maybe on Bitcoin we could put a new low below 41.8, and that would give it a nice structure to go attack 44K. Or not. Or maybe we gotta go to Golden Pocket of the Bounce, which is 40K. And that would be an even better structure to go attack 44 again. But it would give bear, well, it would give the short squeezer squeezed people opportunity to take a smaller loss, I guess. So yeah, if you want to continue the short squeeze scenario, you can dump, but not too much. Because then they're just gonna take profit and you want them trapped, right? So they're still trapped from below 40K, but people who shorted more recently are also trapped, but they're more like trapped from 42.5, somewhere there. Those are, yeah, are not really trapped now. On the stock market, futures are dumping with those news, like 0.5%. So yeah, futures pushed to new all-time highs during the overnight session, like ES did. It put a new all-time high, and yeah, now they're coming back down from that new all-time high.
My check.
I'm good. What's up, Fenris?
Thank you. And not much, just watching the market go down. I wish I could have short. I'm inter alone, but I have bought a few times, like I said that.
You're watching the markets go down while everything's going up. Interesting.
Did I say it like that? Watching the market goes down, but everything is good. Did I actually say it like that? Because then that was a mistake.
Nah, we are going down on the 15 minute, I guess, but overall, it's high.
How long do you think this will go?
It's Friday. We're starting a weekend. I don't think we'll go very far. Probably defining a range already. You know, that 43.6 to 44K is resistance. We can't get above that. And for support, well, we've built a bit yesterday by dumping just below 42. Yeah, maybe that's going to be support. Well, we could just stay between 42 and 44 for the weekend. Maybe, I don't know. I'd like that rather than a dump down below 38. But I'm okay with that too. Well, you know, sideways Bitcoin could be good for some alts. Now, we got some that are already running, like Link. You know, they put new yearly highs. There's a few, and maybe it's a glimpse of the weekend. Or maybe Link already got rejected, is coming back below its previous high, and it's over for Link, and the other coins were not even strong enough to do that. A lot of them did it already. Like, if you look at Blur, Blur had its new high and come back below it last week already. For Solana, it's quite a challenge. It would need to pump above 120. Maybe we can see that this weekend. I don't know.
Let's see, man, because I'm on the long and I'm not happy about it.
Yeah, well, yeah. Where's Matic at? People were talking a lot about Matic yesterday. A mental is below 60 cents. Yeah, Matic 80 cent. Okay, that's exactly where you don't want to trade it. Now, you know, it feels like it's going down, but things are pretty stable, actually. You know, there's a bit of green, a bit of red. We're just either in a distribution or an accumulation pattern on these alts. So. But you know, funding rates are back to positive. So that's not a good sign for my short squeeze continuation.